grateful to the organizer who organized this special lecture for Calabi-Yau festivals. So the paper was published in 1978. Actually, the work was done in 1976. It took 2 years to come out because I submitted the paper to NYU Journal for the friendship with my friends in NYU. Then they don't quite understand geometry. But anyway, I have to say that I'm rather proud of this paper still after 40 years. And I remember I started to look at this problem in 1970 when I was second year graduate student. And I was interested in gravity, and at the same time I was interested in Taylor geometry. So I thought that may be interesting to see the common ground in order to construct more manifolds. But I have no idea what to do. In those days, I was in Berkeley. There was no office for graduate students. So I spent all my life in the library. So I looked around and practically read almost every book in the library, although I don't understand them. And by accident, I saw this paper by Calabi. And I was very excited by it because that gives you the way for me to understand what I want. Because I was interested in constructing a manifold where there's no matter, which in gravity means the Ricci curvature equals zero. And yet, the topology is non-trivial, and gravity is non-trivial. So there's no matter, but there's gravity. That's what I try to construct. And Calabi conjecture provide me a means to do it. But then I look at it, it amounts to the following equation. So you look at this equation, the Calabi conjecture says that you have to solve this equation, where phi is unknown, and this equation we need to solve. It's a very complicated equation because it's very nonlinear, and at that point, nobody thought about the solved equation on the manifold. Most people working on partial differential equations work on a domain, and you put in space and all that. So this is not clear at all that it's possible to solve. And Calabi thought that at the beginning he can solve it, but then he realized that he made many mistakes that he could not do yet. Actually, he told me on the way, told him the subject of matter is not mature enough. Just don't go too far, caveat. That's what he told me at that point. But I was very fascinated by this problem. I thought this is the key to understand geometry. Because in geometry, we have several kinds of curvature that we need to understand. And the major problem is Ricci curvature. And Ricci curvature is beautiful because it equates the metric together by Einstein's equation. So I was always excited by this problem. And I thought this would be the most interesting and exciting problem in mathematics to solve. But at that time, not only me, all my friends were skeptical about Calabi conjecture. Notice that until then, until 1976, we have not a single example of a compact manifold where the Ricci curvature equals zero, and yet the curvature is not zero. So this was the status at that point. So nobody believed that you can construct many of them. Not only you construct one, you construct many. So this was one of the major problems at that point, and yet nobody believed that it's possible. So we worked very hard. This including my friends, Nacho Hichen, and many young geometers at that time. No more young, but at those ones we were very young. We just graduated. We all want to give counter examples to this problem. And counter example is not trivial. We worked very hard on it. Only after three years, after really hard work, I decided to go other way around. Say that because I could not give counter example, there must be something is wrong. Something is wrong means that whole subject of what we call geometric analysis. Because after this, many people start to work on the subject. So I'm sorry that I didn't realize that there's something not expert here. But still. So this provides a first known non-local homogeneous unsigned manifold. All the unsigned manifold was homogeneous, basically, in those days. But it's amazing, right after I declared that I can solve this problem, I found examples. The physicists and many other people immediately come up with many non-compact examples, including Gibbons, Hawking, and Calabi, and all that. Those first examples can be written down, including Yifuji Henshin, all this were written, right, around 77. So this was very nice. One is the psychological problem is not there, we are able to move much faster. And I got famous by the Calabi conjecture, not because of the existence of such a metric, it's because something related to algebraic geometry. So people are excited about it. This is only one of them, which says the second chain class actually can tell you that the universal curve of such a metric must be CN if it's equal to 0. And this is true in general. So the group is in SUN, this led to the structure theorem of Calabi-Yau manifold. And there are some quite a few other applications of this. So in 1980, when I went to the Institute for Advanced Study as a faculty there, my first postdoc was Gary Horowitz. He worked with me as a postdoc in the Institute for Advanced Study. And Andy Stromitzer also came. As a postdoc at that time, he just graduated from MIT. And I keep on asking them, I said, this is a manifold which should have some relevance in physics because it says which curve the equal zero, there's no matter, and yet there's gravity and there's a lot of point about it. And none of them believe what I said. They said it's all nonsense. This you could get and cannot be any relevance to physics at all. But so it comes to my great surprise when 1984, when they call me up and saying that, well, you know, we would like this manifold to exist, and you told me at one point this should be there. So I was very happy to tell them what happened. And at that point, actually, not too many algebraic geometers interested in either. So when Ed Witten called me and said, how many examples can you find? At that point, I think we only know two, maybe three. One is what we call C manifold at this moment. It's an elliptic curve cross elliptic curve divided by single group of order three. And then there's complete intersection in CBN. So that was all examples we thought about at that point. But then immediately, because Andy Stromitzer came on asking me to construct Calabi-Yau manifold with free generator, so I tried to construct those manifolds. It happens that the manifold I construct in 1984, there's a major conference. So I construct one manifold with oil number equal minus 6. And that manifold is in a complete intersection. It's covered by a complete intersection in the product of CP3. So I told Philip Candelas about it, and one can construct more manifolds. Complete intersection in compact projective space, the product of them. So I was totally surprised that he got many, many more in a short time. So now, at that point, and we thought there are only about 10,000 Calabi-Yau manifolds. But of course, by now, you get maybe a few hundred million, which is totally shocking to me. But in any case, even at that time, I thought there only find a number of that, such manifolds. And this is still a important conjecture. The reason I thought the only finite number is related to questions in dependent geometry. Because we know positive Ricci curve is the only finite number, and zero curve, Ricci curve is kind of bounded. So I thought it's true. But it's still not a problem that we solved so far. But in any case, there's no similar theorem in T2 manifolds, which is important, where you want holonomic groups. I must say that it's a great surprise. even though the metric I prove exists cannot be constructed explicitly, and yet we were able to do a huge amount of calculations without knowing the explicit form of the metric. So this is rather amazing to me. And only with the physics coming in that it has been such an important machinery. Now, of course, you all know that when many things has come in. So the very, even at that point, in the first few years of the Calabi-Yau manifold after the string field become popular, many people still do not feel too much about it until this thing about meter symmetry coming in. And so this was originally discovered by several people. I think it's kind of ridiculous to base on such a weak evidence they believe that it should exist. It's kind of amazing to me that it actually exists. In fact, Green was my postdoc at the time, and Ronald Pesser was a student of Kumar. So they came in one day in my office and tell me that meter symmetry should exist. I said, this is all ridiculous, because the examples that I know were all has negative order number. And how could you have equal amount of numbers, which is positive order number? But then, can they construct this big table, which has a symmetry? So he was very good. And then, of course, afterwards, a group of people led by Philip Candelas, they construct this conjecture form of a number of resonant curves arbitrarily in the kingdom, which is a major problem for a long time. And that we like to know the formula. And this, of course, led to a big debate in MSRI in 1990, January. When Singer asked me to run a conference in MSRI, at the beginning it was supposed to be on some other subject. And I told Singer that it's better to run on meter symmetry because it's spectacular. So we have a big conference in meter symmetry in January 1990. And of course, there was a big debate. Our friends in algebraic geometry really do not believe what Candela's formula is, because the formula comes up different. And I think Dave was very upset about that outcome, but Dave wanted to change his side immediately after a couple of months. But anyway, I think it was a very good outcome because mathematicians made a mistake and the physicist won this time, and then everybody was excited about it. And then the subject started to be most popular in mathematics in the last 30 years. So I'm very glad that it happened. Anyway, so at that point, we are interested in counting, which is now called remote written invariant, which is called an A model for logical string. So we are interested in something called a P energy, defined in the following way. That's after a lot of work. For genius equals zero, it has this form where this corresponding to some counting purpose. For genius equals one, it has this form. Where this is the integral over the virtual fundamental cycle on the modular spherical curve of genius G. So construction of this is not trivial due to the intent of all of us, veteran and fantastic. And so this is the counting that I mentioned, put in a rigorous way. The physicists are much more relaxed on defining this at the beginning, but then you take a much longer time to come up with formula. It works well. So, well then, of course, some of these are exciting because the formula that Candela's AL proposed was actually proved independently by two groups of people, and this really justified the physical intuition behind the string theory for this, which I think is very important, psychologically important. So then it comes to my surprise again when ECOE, who are all here, proposed the formula for genius 1 and also high genius later. So genius 1 was finally proved by Singer for using reduced homomorphism field. 14 years ago, Yamaguchi from Japan came to work with me as a postdoc. We tried to understand this DCOV paper, and I decided that it should be simplified, and it should be much more controllable. So we worked out that the B model, the generating function lies in the finite generating dependent ring. So that was not easy. The whole thing would be generated by ring with five generators. So I was hoping that it will look like the Ottawa form field. And so it comes out quite nicely. And later, based on this work, Wong, Clem, and several other people derived an algorithm to determine FGH for G less than 51. I will come back to this later. But this becomes useful, this formula, this conjecture, and because in the last few years, several group of people actually was able to implement this polynomial conjecture, and were able to actually prove things. So that was good. Only after you simplify it in a mathematical way, you can actually prove things. So that was very good. And so as we see, DCOE is proposed a description of high genius D model based on a gauge field, a Calabi-Yau free one. And the free energy of this gauge field gives the generating function of the topological D model, even over the moduli of the linear Calabi-Yau manifold. So linear symmetry predicts that this generating function coincides with this limit, taking this limit. And this is rather puzzling to us, and even the definition is still puzzling. And we still like to understand the definition in a mathematical manner. But they have a beautiful formula for the which is called a holomorphic anomaly equation, where the P model free energy is set to identity. It's one of the most intricate formula that I know of, and I'm still trying to understand what that means. Anyway, we argue the P model generating function lies in the finite generating system. And as I said, they use this polynomial structure that we have and use a gap condition at the corner front part on the moduli space to determine this up to genius 51. And later, with several people postdocs together, we were able to understand the open case, the toric semifinal case. And this is essentially the ring of almost holomorphic module form. And I was hoping that we can contribute to number theory by looking at this ring, similar to the holomorphic form, the ring of the holomorphic form. So in some cases, it's true, but what exactly it would be, we are still interested to know what is that. But anyway, as I mentioned earlier, these are being some progress we make, largely led by Jun Li, very well, I think, depending on how to work out this functional equation. Now, you just listen to the BCOE theory, which was discussed by Sealy and his co-worker, Costello. And I think it's a beautiful work, and since he just talked about it, can keep it. And then, another important progress on Calabi-Yau geometry, beautiful homological linear symmetry proposed by conservatory in 1995. And this is really nice, and you see, amazing enough, this was found before the physicists proposed it. And so conservatory states that the two linear geometry, X and X hat, states that the Foucault category of X is equivalent to the derived category of covariant series of X hat. This was proved by Seidel for the genius 2 curve and cortic surface, and generalized by Sheridan to all Calabi-Yau manifolds and final hybrid surface. And this is really very nice, and a fully faithful mirror function is achieved through the family 4 theory by Abu-C using Lagrangian 5 in the SYC picture, which I will discuss. Then at the same time, in the last 10 years, there were developments by Donaldson and Thomas, the student. And this is Donaldson, Thomas, and Valens. relate the global fitting invariant, which I just mentioned, to the Donald Thomas invariant. And this whole theory was developed by many important people, including topological rhetoric, which is proposed by these four people here. And progress was made in a serious manner, so those quite large power here was proved. So I think this is very beautiful. And then we also try to relate it to the related Donaldson-Thomas theory with the cyber-vision theory. This was discovered by Artis and Aten and Bukov and Marisa and myself. And these are relating the Donaldson-Thomas theory of seeds with two-dimensional support in a non-compact local service people. The driver no over S. And we relate it to the cyber-vision invariant of the surface S and the invariant of the S. So this works out quite nicely, and I think warping will be developed. And this relates to the Waffle Richard invariant, which I think is still very interesting. And very, I believe it was very important to understand this invariant more. Anyway, so it's related to it, to the cyber Richard invariant plus coalescent terms governed by the invariant of the next super scheme. So the research has still been carried out. Now, in all this whole thing, actually, a very important question is the Miller, the period calculation, which is related to old classical literature, started by Euler and all these people. So basically, given a holomorphic free form, which is unique in the Calabi-Yau geometry, we want to know the integral of it over the cycle. So this whole thing is a very important component of the combination in Miller symmetry. And this already carried out by Philip and Dennis in this group, and this is a very important calculation that they did. Now, but for more general manifold, we need to know more about it. And Hosono, who came to be my postdoc also in 1990s, and also his former, in 1996, so we studied hybrid surface in polar variety, and we look at what a large compass structure limit is, and we call it Y infinity, given by some divisor, and then we compute the period of Y near Y infinity by first finding a complete solution to a GKC system. So GKC system was introduced by three Russians, and it's a beautiful system of ODE, PDE, holomorphic partial dependent equation. And so we make it to be, we make use of it to compute the period. But it's not so easy, because it doesn't work sometimes. And anyway, in the meantime, Todorov, Bong Liang and I characterized Y infinity in terms of neuromorphic, global neuromorphic top form. So to know what a large complex structure is. That is related to the monotonic group, of course. So anyway, the important thing to compute period is that the period near this divisor corresponding counting terms. So the general problem is how to compute such a thing. So we want to construct an explicit complete linear PDE system, tau, for the seed. And this is a system so that the solution space should be exactly the periods. That's what we want to know. So we want to construct a system of partial dependent equations so that all the solutions equal to the periods. That's what we want to do. And this turns out to be not easy. Not enough for doing that. And after, the reason why we want to do it is that then we can explicitly compute a period as power series and determine local and even global monotonic periods. And then we can count the curves in the algebraic varieties by Miller symmetry. So, in 2010, Bong Liang and I developed a theory which we call topological system. We found out by the Fourier transform of the defining ideal of the embedding of X. The topological embedding, that's why we call it topological system. And also some first order symmetric operator, symmetry operator, induced by the ambient space symmetry. So when we have a group together, and when the group is a toroid, that means it becomes a toric variety, But we actually found a characterization. So for any homogeneous G variety, so the NPM manifold would be a group variety acting by group G, and this system is complete. That means you solve everything, even only if the primitive part of X is equal to zero. So that's what we prove. And this allows us to give a description of solution to a dependent system part in topological terms. So this gives you a lot of efficient calculation for such a period for the purpose of the meter system. And in application, my student Yu is interested in understanding the works by Canderas and his group regarding Calabi-Yau varieties over finite field. So we look into that, and then we explain it in terms of this. We took a universal family of Calabi-Yau dividing over integers, and given any pi number after reduction mod p, we have the probability and the volume acting on O y by raising functions in power. Then we get a p-semilinear morphism of this type using certain base here by a junction formula. This gives rise to the Hessian Greek matrix here. And the appropriate limit of a scaling of this will give rise to unit holomorphic period family over the complex number at the rare one point, the large complex structure point. So this is good. This gives you some understanding of how to deal with Calabi-Yau over integer, over what key. So we hope that we can develop this more and hopefully will be useful for a number of fields. Now let's come to SYC. So this is an astrologer, myself, Sato. First time I know the author behind me. So my name is always hi, everybody. Anyway, so Eric Sato was my postdoc at that time. And at that time, we just inspired by the deep brain theory. And it was good that I was in Trias for the conference, and Edmonton, and several others, and Andy Strong. Well, Andy was not there. Andy was asking me about spectral content. Is it good or not? So I said, it looks very good. And after I come back to Harvard, and we work on this disaster, and then Andy comes for an interview, actually. So we start to look at this topic. So what we do is this. The Calabi-Yau manifold is a fiber over a three-dimensional manifold, a base, not necessarily not singular, where the fiber are torus, three-dimensional torus, which are special Lagrangian, and these are the planes. And then we take a T duality along here, get the linear manifold. And we assert there exists a fiber-wise Fourier mechanism from which metal Lagrangian submetal here to a Fourier shift on the other side. So that's what we proposed in 1996. And I think this is rather fruitful, and all the way up to now, it has been inspiring for many interests as well. So at that point, we worked out with my other student, Kongen Lab, that if we meet up here, CY manifold, central SYC, then the fiber-wise Fourier mechanical form of a special Lagrangian session produces a homomorphic light bundle on the mirror, which satisfies this deformed Harrison-Youngers equation. So this is rather interesting to me. So the left-hand side corresponds to what we call special Lagrangian cycle. C is a p-dimensional manifold where omega, the Taylor form, is changing to equal zero. This means special Lagrangian, this whole thing together. Under the Fourier Mackay transform, it transforms the Lie bundle, which satisfies these two equations. So it should be holomorphic Lie bundle, and it satisfies this equation, which we call deformed Harrison-Young music. This equation is fascinating, and we did not know this equation until this thing come up in a natural manner. And in fact, SYC construction, the special Lagrangian was actually proposed by Harvey and Lawson, not knowing about anything related to this operation. And several people worked on this. My former student Ron worked on this, and resource goes into growth, and they construct Lagrangian five basins for Tohoku Calabi-Yau effort, and this has been rather fruitful. And then it was followed by several people, and let me not go into great detail about it, but it was interesting that we try to construct such a five basin by using by kind of approximating Calabi-Yau metric by the local model, which constructed by Kunlun and Wuli, Wafa metric, and then try to glue it on the semi-grad metric that we have there. And this turns out to be useful. Gross Nielsen, actually, at my suggestion, tried to say that it's okay. But unfortunately, at the last minute, when they do the paper, they still use my original proof. And that means that it's not powerful enough to give information about the incident by collapse. Despite that was the original purpose. Anyway, so many people work on this. How to get a quantum collapse to the SYC construction. So Dennis Oros proposed that the counting of holomorphies that bounce a smooth toroid fiber drastically change when light goes across a certain wall in the base of SYC vibration, displaying a wall-causing phenomenon. And then it was developed more and more by several groups of people to construct SYC mirror. And a typical example is live window over PM and tonic variety and several other people were constructed. So let me not go into detail that. And then, of course, there's a question of scattering and the wall structure and all that, all becomes very intricate and deep really developed by related to conservative soil movement for the wall, universal wall causing formula and the scattering of holomorphisms in the formula. So this is a beautiful development. And Gross Siebert developed a beautiful reconstruction program of mirrors, which uses the wall forcing formula to capture quantum correction combinatorics. So these are all very, very nice. And now, I'd like to go into a little bit different subject, which I think is interesting. At least mathematically. This was proposed, I think, by several people. And it's kind of forgotten nowadays. I'd like to remind you when I can. So we like to consider manifolds that are not tailored, but whose canonicalization is trivial. And these are manifolds that proposed by Clemens and Freeman, and then make something called V-Center. What does that mean? He said, even any Calabi-Yau free form, it can be deformed and moistened of manifold fit into a single universal modular space where Calabi-Yau of different homotopy types are connected to one another through conformal transition. So this was a proposal that V made, but he doesn't want to call it a proposal because I think he was not sure it. But anyway, it's a beautiful speculation that all the Calabi-Yau can be linked together through a construction. So what does a construction go? So you first contract this drawn resonant curve, which results in a Calabi-Yau free form, the double point singularity, and then deform the singular space into a smooth compact vector. So that was the proposal, which I think is beautiful if it works. And well, if it works, that means every manifold, Calabi-Yau manifold, will be linked by resonance to the manifold after deformation to second Bennett number of zero. And therefore, the smooth out complex manifold can be a connection of SP cross SP. So all the complicated Calabi-Yau manifold is all linked to the connection of SP cross SP. Just like a handleboard that you see in two-dimensional. So if this is true, that would be beautiful. And, but it's difficult to work on it because they are not tailored. So one needs to build some structure over it. And so we need to build some additional geometric structure on here. And I like to look into this system of supersymmetric equations from heterotic strings that are known as the Shing-Tung system. comparison of a stable bundle over the complex manifold, and that arithmetic is required to satisfy something called balanced condition in order to satisfy the supersymmetric condition. And this is an interesting, beautiful system of equations. For a long time, there was no solution to that system. Non-singular solutions. And only after 10 years, Fu and myself gave the first solution on a compact on Taylor people, which is a toroid bundle over KP surface. So this gives rise to a solution to the geometry system, first non-singular solution, which I think is very nice. And then two students of mine and Kikai in Columbia University, they found geometry system solution on many non-Taylor compact manifolds with infinitely many topological types and Hodge numbers. Now, I'm not sure whether they are physical, but they are infinite number of topological types and Hodge numbers. So mathematically, they are very interesting. Now, for the Hammond construction, I look at 10 years ago, around 2002, I work with Smith and Thomas and do a sympathetic construction, and where we call the manifold to be Calabi-Yau if the first trend class of the sympathetic manifold is zero, and they are in general non-Taylor manifold. So what we do is that we take these strong Lagrangian free spheres of the Taylor Calabi-Yau and collapse it and replace it by sympathetic two sphere. The resulting six manifold would still be sympathetic, but its third bending number must be zero. So these manifolds are going to be connect sum of CP3. So the complex case is connect sum of S3 cos S3, and this case would be connect sum of CP3. So they look very nice due to each other, but so far we have not been able to make sense of the derived in a very concrete manner. So I hope that it will become useful eventually. Anyway, so we have hopefully to construct this with some meter symmetry and all that, which we have tried, and it works out reasonable, but not really great detail yet. Now let's go to Calabi-Yau comp, which is an interesting class of manifold, which involves under the name of Sasaki manifold. So as Uguri said, Sasaki was a mathematician in Chia. So that's very good. Expect that we are working on this kind of thing. So it is a cone, metric cone, where T bars are the length of the cone, and there's a vector field associated to this geometry, and this generates C star F on the manifold length. And this is a Taylor cone, if only the length is Sasaki manifold, this vector field is this vector field. So this is a beautiful geometry. And we have been working on it for some time, actually. And this can be embedded as a fiber variety in CN for some large n, so that theta is induced by a homomorphic vector field. And motivated by ABS-CFT correspondency, it's natural to ask, when does such a manifold and this Litchin effect theta come back? So that was an important question. And, well, turns out there are restrictions on X, which we have to consider. We call X invisible if X is Q, for instance, and X has a very long tendency in R. So that's the condition. And there are examples of such variety defined by big homogeneous polynomial. For example, this is an important example of such variety. And now, so there's a conjecture that I made actually many years ago, more generally, you can construct more generally. So there was a conjecture I make actually. This manifold and this K-line dimension forces which version in the known if is K-stable. And then those are K-stability is purely algebraic condition. And this was finally proved by Prof. Chen, Donaldson, and Son about 4 years ago. So there was a big major progress. And so these are actually interesting questions related to physics evaluation. Material and spark, James Spark was about to stop at the time about 15 years ago. We found obstruction to existence of which is that cone metric and explain how this obstruction could be interpreted in terms of the ABS CFT field. And then this was developed more and more by several people. And finally, Tristan Collins found a note of case stability. And this was good. This case stability is defined in terms of subtle algebraic properties of this rate. So now you have a condition for the applied algebraic variety to be the Calabi-Yau cone. And they proved this important theorem. There are five varieties with this weather field, and this is Richard Flagg Taylor cone metric. If and only if it's case stable. And this can be used to determine, for example, for this five variety, that it emits a case stability condition if and only if 2p is bigger than q and 2q is bigger than p. So using this correspondence, we propose an interpretation of case stability in q-free design. The interpretation is in terms of the chiral rate and the generalized central charge. That's my idea. So it's quite interesting. Now, I like to talk about stability in Calabi-Yau topics. So this is a question related to digital stability. And it's still possible to me, but we are trying to explore what that means. And I think, to me, everything should have a geometric meaning. And this is what we try to look for. Anyway, motivated by deep brain stability, Douglas, Dietrich introduced the notion of stability of triangular category D. And given a Calabi-Yau manifold, we can associate two triangular category D. There's a derived higher category, which only depends on the synthetic structure. And then there's a derived category of coherency, so picture stability conditions are supposed to cover the other half of the geometric structure, namely the stability condition of the higher category cover the complex structure, and stability condition on the right coherency cover the synthetic structure. So that was the proposal. Now, in order to study this condition, consider the following thing. The mirror of special Lagrangian space through the SY system. The mirror of special Lagrangian, as I mentioned earlier, is a so-called deformed Hamiltonian space. This equation was actually discovered by Greg Walsh, Schrödinger, and translate this language into Eldritch Western terms. So we're still working on it. Now, so what's the point that I was trying to do? From the conditions in the field, we find obstructions and excesses of sorts in the following way. We propose that if the excision is frozen to the deformed Calabi-Yau prism, then for every proper irreducible subvariety of the Calabi-Yau manifold, the dimension equal to T. This condition should hold. So what is this condition? This is a central charge defined by this condition and this condition. So we prove that if there exists frozen, then the divide it and then take the imaginary one. So this looks like a rich transgressive condition to us. And we prove that it is related to the deformed Calabi-Yau condition. And we believe that this would be true, that they are more or less equivalent. And we prove that it doesn't prove this because these are actually equivalent excesses for frozen to the deformed Calabi-Yau condition. So at least we know it's true for two dimensions, Calabi-Yau. So five dimensions becomes typical. We still work on it. And this relates to some interesting trend number in code for solving this deformed Calabi-Yau condition. And but this inequality that comes up in this way, I think, is very interesting because this is the first time such a stability condition has come up in a natural manner. So I hope that this could be four more for supporting beach stability and all these